Hello everyone, welcome to episode 21 of this awesome, incredible Osu! Let's Play series. In the last episode, I talked about alternating maps, what that means basically, what the skill sets are that go into that, and some simple maps of alternating style as well. And in this episode, I want to talk about reading. So reading, pattern processing, I'll talk about what's called chunking, and I will try not to get too into the nitty-gritty, although it's probably going to end up happening anyway. I do want to mention, though, also that if you have not seen my video called OCPhD, I feel like I've probably shouted it out in like every episode so far, at least the more recent ones, but highly, highly recommend checking that out first, to be honest. If you're watching this video and you have not seen OCPhD, please pause the video and go watch that first. It'll be linked in the description. But yes, real quick, before we begin, I also want to shout out that I live stream every single day over at twitch.tv/digitalhypno. So if you want to hang out with me or watch me play this game live, anything like that, would be very, very happy for you to stop by and say hello. And bonus points, if you tell me that you came from this Let's Play series, I will be very, very happy to see you there. So yes, without any further ado, as usual, let's get started. So let's look at the first map that I have picked out. So I think it's six maps. Let me check. Seven. Oh god, okay, seven maps to get through for this episode. I picked out a couple maps. I might not actually get to all of them, but that's the first map. So reading is okay, so now at this point I'm assuming you've all seen OCPG. Okay, so, and I got 100 on the first note. So reading is probably, like I said in OCPHD, I think one of the most misunderstood. And it is basically about like breaking the pattern down into something that's very digestible. And the comparison I usually make is to reading a language, for example. Like, let's say, for example, you are learning, like, okay, so let's say, for example, that you don't speak Russian. If you do speak Russian, then this, hopefully it'll make sense. But, you know, you probably know what Russian looks like, at least. The alphabet's very, it kind of looks similar to English, but basically it's a different alphabet, right? And when you're learning a language with a new alphabet, you go from, like, taking, like, 20 minutes just to figure out what all the sounds in a word mean, and, like, figuring out how to pronounce a word, and then eventually, you know, long story short, you get to the point where you can just look at a word and you instantly, you not only know how to pronounce it, but you also know exactly what it means, like without even thinking, right? And this is usually what happens with your native language, right? Like when you're listening to me speak right now, you don't even need to think about like what the words I'm saying mean. Like it's just automatic. Like you can't even not understand what I'm saying if you wanted to. And that sort of like skill gap learning, basically, of like processing. Oh, I almost missed. What? That's very strange. Okay, you guys didn't see that. Yeah, that like process of getting better at, well, processing information is, I think, very, very relatable to OSU as a whole and OSU reading. But I think at the basis of reading in this game is breaking things down into their more basic properties, I guess. And in the case of OSU reading, okay, so there is what I call chunking, which is basically you take like a more complex pattern and you like split it in your head into like separate parts. It's basically like, okay, so if a sentence had no spaces at all, like let's say all this text up here, if there were just no spaces, I'm sure you'd still be able to read it and probably understand what it means, but it's kind of strange. You have to put in a lot more effort. And chunking is basically putting those spaces between each word so that you can process things one part at a time and one like meaningful bit of information at a time. So some words are longer than others, but still you can just break things down into what is digestible and simple to understand. And that is what lets you read things quickly, because if there were no spaces, then you'd probably still be able to read, but you know, it would probably be challenging, and also some words might blend together. So yes, very, very tricky. I will try to show you an example of what I'm talking about. This map, it's map number two, the absolute classic. All right, let's play with it and hopefully Actually, I do have a score on this with Hidden. Actually, I'll just play it anyway. I'm sure you guys by now, you can all read Hidden. You don't need this to be played with Nomad for this example to work. Okay, so towards the end of the map, there's these like triangle thingies that kind of go cross screen. And okay, I'm just pausing to say this now to make sure I don't like take too long to explain this and then get to the end of the map. And okay, anyway, I want you guys to try processing those jumps at the end into like distinct groups of three, and that is what's called chunking, basically. So we're chunking the ending pattern into groups of three and playing them one part at a time, rather than trying to process them sort of all at once, right, as one just like giant unit. But anyway, this map is an absolute classic. One inspiration for using this map in particular, well, it is somewhat reading dense, but I think I got it from one of my friends who I think he had a score on it, and I was like, oh my gosh, the score is so wholesome. And then I think I wanted to beat it too, so something like that. But yes. Okay, I think it's coming soon. Oh yeah, after the spinner. Oh wait, what? Where is it? Where is it? Okay, here. Yeah, those little, like, they're cut in threes, but it's not new combo in threes, and oh. Kind of tricky. But if you try to process it as one thing, it becomes a lot more overwhelming, especially with the whole, like, cut in spacing. It would be a bit odd if I just, like, missed on them while trying to explain how to play them. Okay, we're good. But yes, hopefully that somewhat starts painting a picture on what I mean by chunking. So usually I think like the simplest sections to split objects is in groups of two or three for the most part, from what I've experienced. And that's part of the reason why 1-2 jumps, you know, those jumps that you find in PP maps, farm maps, they tend to be new comboed in groups of twos. Because, so like in, I didn't mean to go back. Okay, let's look at this map, for example, for a little bit. Spoiler alert, that is the next map that I'm going to show you guys. But okay, let's look at this in the editor. All right, so like these patterns, for example, they're not new comboed. If they were new comboed, like, okay, so if I could just click on one of them, I can either click this new combo button here or press the Q button on my keyboard, and that makes a new combo. So if the pattern was like this, it might actually be a little easier for you to read. Or even if it was like this, to be honest, if I click on this one and make that a new combo as well. This is sort of how you might want to chunk the pattern. Although it's not done like that for you. Like if I press Control Z and undo those, then this is what you're actually seeing in the map. And if you're able to break it down, Control Y to redo, if you're able to break it down like this, I think it's a lot easier to digest and basically just focus on playing one chunk at a time and then moving on to the next chunk and playing that, and then so on and so forth. So for this, obviously you read this triangle as one thing and then you move on to the next chunk and you sort of play that as one thing as well. So personally, all right, let's go back to song list. I'm not sure if I've actually explained this, but I use the escape button to leave the editor mode, and then so leaving the editor and going back to the normal song list, escape, and then bottom left corner I mash the back button, I mash the left click to hit the back button, and then I mash the Osukuki to get back to the song list. That is how I do that very quickly. I think some people have asked, I've posted some stream highlights where I have made, or I've like been in the editor and then left very quickly, and that is how I do that. So it's in case you guys are curious. Alright, next map, absolute classic. This map is amazing. And so far all the maps that I've been showing are approach rate 8. Typically on higher star reading, at least, I think AR8 is sort of what's considered reading dense, reading heavy. And there's sort of a generational divide there because that didn't used to be the case, but I digress. Okay, so I want to describe a bit more about chunking and how I sort of see it as a three-step process, like playing each chunk. So first step, okay, so basically it's like for each chunk there should be like three steps that you go through to play each one, and you'll notice that they all sort of revolve around making sure you hit the first note of each chunk properly. But first, okay, so step number one of playing a chunk is make sure you land the first note properly. Because I think hitting the first note of a chunk is, I think, if you mess that up, then everything else is going to get thrown off too. And if you hit the first note right, then I think you'll be in a good spot. So, yes, step one of three, make sure you hit the first note. Step two is just focus on like playing the rest of that chunk to completion. And that is like all the way up to the last note. So in those triangles that we saw in the last map, I would say like step one is hit note number one, and then step two is make sure you hit notes number two and three. And then step three is make sure you stick the landing, basically, from the end of chunk number one to the start of chunk two. So in other words, step three is make sure the next step one is correct, basically. So yes, step one, hit the first note. Step two, hit the rest of the notes. And then step three is don't mess up step one in the next time, basically. But I think, oh, look at those squares, crazy. This map is so good. I think understanding this whole, like, I guess three-step chunking process is really important in, oh, look at that 1-3 stream. it's really important in, especially like really weird patterns that tend to get mind blocked on easily. So I would say cut streams, for example. People, I think, often ask or like are mystified by how to play cut streams consistently. And if you understand this chunking process, it actually makes it a lot easier to digest cut streams, I would say. So yes. And on the topic of Mindblock, I do want to shout out that over at OSU University, which is this improvement-focused OSU hub, I have done a series of interviews with different top players where we went really, really deep into the topic of Mindblock, which is basically like when you used to be able to play a pattern properly, and then now you, after playing the map more, you just completely, you can't hit the pattern for some reason, and you just have no idea why. That is what Mindblock is. I did touch on it in OSU PhD, which hopefully you guys have seen by now if you're at this part of the video. But yes, if you want to hear all the advice, like more advice than you could possibly ever want about Mindblock, definitely check out the playlist of Mindblock interviews over at OC University. I'll have that linked in the description. But yes, with that, let's move on to map number four. So now that I've sort of planted the seed, wait, let's turn off mods. And again, just okay, just a review in case you guys have not seen the earlier episodes, to go over the shortcuts that I used to clear mods. So to clear the mods here, I press F1 to enter the mods panel, and then I press the 1 button, reset all mods, and then 2 again. So that very quickly and unconsciously almost, I'm able to turn off the mods and switch back to new mod. So yes, let's go. So yes, now that I've sort of planted the seed of reading, I guess, I advise you sort of, at least for the time being, from now on, like every time you watch OSU gameplay, try to sort of like chunk patterns consciously. Like try to apply those chunking methods, even when you're not even playing, like while you're watching this gameplay, like try to see if you can chunk the patterns into like smaller groups. And the whole point of that is because, as with learning anything, or like I guess building a new habit of, or like way of doing something, I think doing it like, okay, so being very deliberate and conscious in the way that you like doing it, the way that you want to, like the more you do something unconsciously, the easier it'll be to do unconsciously, basically. So the more you like, every time you watch an OSU map and you just try to chunk the patterns in your own head, it's going to become easier to do it like unconsciously, like without even thinking, when you play the game yourself, hopefully. Or just, you know, if you're just watching, if you're someone who, okay, it's unrelated as well, but I respect the community of OSU people who don't really play the game, but they just sort of watch the game, follow the community, consume content. I think it's a very respectable decision. Actually playing the game is not necessarily for everyone. I think probably most gaming communities are like that, but anyway, I digress. Yes, I think, and this applies to things other than OSU as well, but yes, if you are trying to learn a new way to do something, just focusing on doing it consciously until you start doing it unconsciously. That's probably a pretty good rule of thumb that you can apply to pretty much anything. I think some people ask me about like, I have like a bad habit of over tapping on doubles or triples or something like that, or like my tapping technique is really bad or something like that, and I'm trying to fix it. The answer that I usually give all those questions is just play some very simple stuff so that you're not overwhelmed by trying to do like a bunch of different skills. And yes, just play some simple stuff and focus very consciously on, oh my god, what is this pattern? Focus very consciously on like doing what you are trying to be able to do, or like the new way of tapping or whatever that you are trying to do. And over time, as you do it consciously more and more, then it will become more natural for you to do it unconsciously. So hopefully that makes sense. Would you call this a tech map? Pop quiz from episode 19, I think. Yeah, 19. I'm starting to forget my numbers. Oh my god. I'm actually kind of surprised that it doesn't feel like we're at episode 21 already. Although I might watch this episode in the future and be like, man, now we're at episode 120. And I'm not gonna know what to do with myself, but anyway. it feels like I've barely started this series, but it's a bit unrelated, but I appreciate all the support and feedback that you guys have given me on this series. So just keep it up, you guys are awesome. Cool. This map. Solid. Honestly, this map is kind of reading oriented. I think I mostly just like the song and I wanted to show you guys the map. It is pretty tricky though, I would say. It's only one SS for Chaos Lutz. Chaos Lutz, very good accuracy player. There's a lot of unique SS scores, which by that I mean like he's the only person with an SS rank on that map. He has a lot of those. And this is one example. Not intended, but it just so happens to be because he has so many of them. But anyway, let's see. Okay, how long have I been recording? 17 minutes. Okay, I have time for... I have time for all three of these, right? I have time for these maps. Okay, quickly though. Okay, map number 5. Good map. This map is AR... Oh no, it's AR9. Okay. Yeah, I did want to touch also on a portrait. I mentioned earlier in the video that there's this sort of generational divide, I guess, between like approach rate and like what people consider like reading, like a reading map or like low approach rate. It also sort of depends on like, you know, even if you are a relatively new player, it just depends on what kinds of maps you play. I think in general, lower, like as long as you can read the speed of like approach rate, then lower density is typically more comfortable to play because there's less like pattern processing chunking required. So that's typically why you'll find like higher AR on, I guess, more modern maps and also like farming maps. They try to make it like, I don't know what other way to put it. They try to dumb it down for you so that it's just like really easy to just like play the map over and over again. They're like hijacking your dopamine. It's like, OMG, play my map for a big PP. That's pretty much how I see it. Although, you know, only one opinion. You can have your own opinion and that's perfectly okay. But also one thing is that you'll notice, okay, so some maps, like modern maps might be like AR, oh, look at that pattern. Like AR 9.2, 9.3, for example, like decimal, like there's a decimal in the approach rate. That used to not be possible, actually. If you look at older maps, like none of them have a decimal. And that is exactly why. Like it's either like AR 8, AR 9, some like really crazy maps, like the Big Black Airman, I think those are AR 10. Because the decimal AR did not exist back then. So I don't remember what year, probably 2014, 15, if I had to guess, but yeah. Cool. Look at this ending, it's been crazy. I don't know why, I felt the need to not interrupt the song during that part. Very good map. Actually, this map is not available for download on the website, but you can look around. There's some places where you can download maps anyway that I probably shouldn't. You can find your own way, but it's a very cool song, very cool map. Okay, those of you who have made it this far in the episode, congratulations. I'm going to show you one of the greatest maps in the game. Dancing Kung Fu. This map is absolutely incredible. This is just an Osu gem. It's mapped by Bakabaka. Wait, it's mapped by Bakabaka. It's the same guy who mapped Answer. Bakabaka. Answer. Same mapper. Incredible. Absolutely just stunning. It's a gift to the Osu community. But yes, this is Dancing Kung Fu. Okay, watch this, watch this. This is CS5 Air 8. It's an incredible map. Yes, on the topic of, I guess, generational divide still, I'm going to try to get through this point by the end of the video. But yeah, so for that reason, but also, I think I've mentioned this as well in a previous episode where I think like 2013-ish, like give or take, like around those years, people sort of considered as like the golden era of Osu mapping. Basically, 2013 is after people started figuring out what they were doing, but before PP mapping abuse started to be a thing. I mean, PP actually didn't really exist in 2013. Or it did, but it was not really the same as what we know today. So yeah, mapping was a lot more, I don't know, for fun, from the soul rather than from some other part of the body. But yeah, I think in like for that reason, you will find older maps tend to be like, I don't know, have more of an emphasis on reading. Maybe not necessarily because they were trying to challenge reading back then, but because mappers nowadays are deliberately trying to not challenge reading, or at least the mainstream farm maps, that's sort of their intention. So I feel like this Let's Play series so far is taking a sort of like anti-farm map, like Osu political approach to the game. Not necessarily trying to be that way, but you know, just shedding some light on another perspective on those maps that you know and love. They're very popular, but yeah, I've had this sort of thought in my mind recently that like what money is in the real world society is basically like PP and Osu. I will not elaborate on that thought more yet in this video, but just planting the seed, see what sticks, you know, if anyone wants to just like just think about that for a little bit. Oh, look at this pattern, look at this pattern. Insane Dancing Kung Fu. Look at this guy, he's just going crazy. Oh, that, wait, I meant to like draw body, but then I ended up just drawing like very large legs. Okay, that was weird. But yeah, reading, pattern processing, I think when asking for like what kinds of maps you should play to challenge reading, I think people probably suggest, oh, just play old maps or something like that. It's usually for this reason, but, and also some people might suggest to play easy mod because that mod, as I mentioned at the end of OCPHD, it cuts the approach rate in half, and it requires much more, like, it'll force you to need to, like, have very good chunking abilities, pattern processing, like, grouping things into digestible sections. Hopefully that makes sense. Absolute banger of a song, of a map. It's just absolutely incredible. there was one more map that I was going to show you guys, but probably better to save it for another time. I think we should probably end it on Dancing Kung Fu because it's just an absolute, just an incredible, it's an absolutely brilliant map. But yes, people suggest using the easy mod to practice. Just play easy and you'll get better at reading. It's because when you play easy, it forces you to be able to chunk patterns into more digestible sections. It's because there's so much going on the screen at once. I'll also throw out, and in case anyone wants to dive further into this, what's called the magic number 7, basically, where like maybe some of you are familiar with this. Your short-term memory is only capable of holding 7 items at once, plus or minus 2-ish, give or take. But 7 items could be 7 different chunks, or it could be 7 individual circles, basically. Hopefully that makes sense. Basically, if you chunk things into digestible sections, then it becomes a lot easier. You have a lot more like mental mental storage storage in your mind to process different patterns. But yeah, with that, hopefully everything made sense, and let me know in the comments what future topics you would want me to cover, because I do read every comment and I appreciate all of them. But yes, hopefully you learned something new, and if you are watching in the future, definitely check out my channel, watch my future videos, because I upload these every single day. And also check me out on twitch.tv/digitalhypno, where I live stream every day as well. But yes, with that, we'll see you guys next time.